हेलो एवरीवन, गुड शेपर्ड्स हाई स्कूल बेलापुर वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर ऑनलाइन लर्निंग सेशन स्टैंडर्ड 7th सब्जेक्ट जनरल साइंस लेसन नंबर 5 टॉपिक फूड सेफ्टी. लेट्स रिकॉल कंप्लीट द फॉलोइंग चार्ट विद द करेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन. Food sources, nutrients obtained and function in body. Jowar, wheat, millet, bajra, rice. What nutrients we get? We get carbohydrates. And what is the function of carbohydrates in our body? It provides energy, providing of energy. Okay. Second, beans and pulses. What nutrients obtained in that? Proteins. And function, what is the function of proteins in our body? Growth and development of body, repairing wear and tear of the body. Oil, ghee, what are the nutrients obtained? Fats. We get fats from oil and ghee. And what is the function in our body? It gives us energy, provides energy. Fruits and vegetables. What are the nutrients obtained? Vitamins and minerals. And what are the functions of vitamins and minerals in our body? Gives immunity and resistance. Helps in all life processes. So children, in this COVID, we have to take lot of vitamins and minerals. So we should eat fruits and vegetables. Okay, children? Yeah. All the constituents of food. What are the constituents of food? Carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, fiber, and water. They are very necessary for the proper growth of the body. Correct, children? We get nutrients from the food materials like wheat, jowar, pulses, rice, vegetables, fruits, etc. However, what will happen if these food materials are infested by insects or spoiled in any way? Infest means what? Infested by insects means it is affected by insect. Then what will happen? Yes, children? We will fall ill if we consume that thing. Correct, no? Yes, now food spoilage, the topic is food spoilage. What exactly it is, we will learn now. See the picture they have shown here. In the picture, what it is? A mice is eating the grains, correct? Then this vada pav, see how you eat, no, on the stalls. See all flies are flying. So any dirt can also settle on the food, and if you will eat, you will fall ill. See all the veggies and all, how that fruit seller, she is sitting, and around her, see all the rubbish is fallen there, all dirt and all, and from there only we buy fruits and all. See this also, near the sack, the dirt is also accumulated there. These are the events in our surroundings, children, and these are the main factors responsible for food spoilage. So let me explain you what is the meaning of food spoilage first. Food spoilage means unpleasant change in color, odor, texture, quality, taste, resulting into loss of food nutrient contents. So that is called food spoilage, children. If you have, suppose at home your mummy kept food and she forgot to warm it, then what it will happen? Yes, it will become stale. Or if you will open the tin, the odor will come. Odor means bad smell will come. So you will like to eat food? No, you will not at all eat that thing. So we call it it's a food spoilage, correct? And it will lose all the nutrients also. You will not be able to eat or taste also. So that's the reason we can call it food spoilage. Okay, children? So factors responsible for food spoilage. First, natural causes. Let me tell you, the foodstuff may spoil due to natural causes. All foodstuffs have their own shelf life. Fruits or their skin turn black and may give out a foul or bad odor. Got it, children? Fruits also get spoiled. It looks black or bad odor means bad smell will come. Okay, this is the one reason. Second is man-made cause. How? When there is wrong handling, overcooking, or improper storage, like storing in damp place or problems during transportation, it results into food spoilage. Third, properties of foodstuffs. There are some intrinsic factors within the food material which results into food spoilage, like milk, meat, etc. may be acidic or alkaline and they get spoiled early. If you will not cook milk on time or meat, it will get spoiled. Then chemical reaction. Some foodstuffs undergo chemical reactions on contact with metals and are spoiled. Sometimes if you cook food in a wrong vessel, it may get spoiled and then you can't eat that food in a proper nutrition, like you will not get a proper nutrition from that and it may get spoiled also. Okay, next, microorganisms and insects. Sometimes foodstuffs may be spoiled due to contamination by microorganisms or insects from the surrounding air, water or soil. So these are the factors responsible for food spoilage, children. Let me repeat it again. Factors responsible for food spoilage. First is natural causes, like fruits or their skin turn black and may give out a foul or bad odor. Second reason is man-made cause, storing in a damp place or problems during transportation, improper storage, wrong handling may cause food spoilage. Third is properties of foodstuffs like milk and meat may be acidic or alkaline and they get spoiled early. Chemical reaction. Some foodstuffs undergo chemical reactions on contact with metals and then they get spoiled. Microorganisms and insects. Sometimes foodstuffs may be spoiled due to contamination by microorganisms or insects from the surrounding air, water or soil, children. Okay. Then, importance of saving the food from spoilage. See, with the help of science and technology, India is producing ample foodstuffs such as cereals, fruits, vegetables, fish, as well as milk and milk products. However, many people in our country and all over the world, there is a problem of starvation and hunger. Many do not get enough food and hence we should not waste the food. So this is an importance of saving the food from spoilage. You should always take care of food and you should not see. Can you give some other examples of factors that cause spoilage of food? I said no, man-made causes, properties of foodstuffs and all. Okay, how and where is food wasted? Yes, children, what you can give the answer? you must have seen wedding buffet system is there, then two people are taking many plates and they are taking in lot, and if they do not be able to eat, then what, they throw it like that only. So that's in a wastage. So it should not happen, because in our country problems, biggest problem is starvation and hunger. Many people are not getting proper food, a proper diet. Got it, children? Next, quantitative wastage of food. What is the meaning of quantitative wastage of food? First, I'll give in point, I'll explain it in the point. First point is using wrong methods of farming, children. Example, hand sowing of seeds, inadequate threshing, improper storage, wrong methods of distribution of food, etc. These are the first reason, quantitative wastage of food. Second is feast and banquets resulting into lots of quantitative loss. Quantitative means, children, in it's bade paimane pe, bade quantity mein food waste hota hai. Improper traditions like offering the excessive food. Why we should give excessive food? We should serve little bit. If they want, they will ask. Correct, no? So these are the quantitative wastage of food. These are the reasons where people are wasting food like that only. Next is qualitative wastage of food. First point, using wrong methods of food preservation, children. Excessive use of food preservatives may lead to wastage of food or spoilage of food. Second, washing the vegetables after cutting them. Overcooking the food. See, children, if you will cut if you will wash your vegetables after cutting, all the nutrients will go away. Okay, next, miscalculation of the time required to transport food from producers to consumers. Means if you will delay in transportation of any foodstuff from one place to another, see, in particular time, if you will not provide to the consumer, then food will get spoiled. Mishandling of perishable fruits like grapes and mangoes. Mango, you know, na, if it will fall down, then it is spoiled. Always remember. So while handling grapes and mangoes may cause qualitative wastage of food, you will not get a proper nutrients in that. Okay, next, what can you do to prevent food wastage and spoilage? First, serve yourself only as much as you can eat. Avoid overcooking food. Third, avoid throwing away leftover food. Reuse it in a proper way. Yes, you can make manure also. Buy only as much grain, vegetables, fruits, milk, etc. as you need. Avoid the temptation to make excessive purchases. Store grains and other perishable foodstuffs like vegetables, fruits, milk, etc. using proper methods. Check the expiry date of bottled, canned, packed food and use within that time. Eat all the food that you have served yourself. Children, this question, you remember it, learn it properly, and you should implement in your daily life also. Okay, children? And one thing, on every 16th October, World Food Day is observed. And this day is observed to create awareness among the people for working towards food security and to avoid food wastage. Okay, children? Next, food storage and preservation. We have learnt about various methods of safe storage of food like freezing, drying, boiling, airtight packaging, etc. Correct? So these different methods help in preventing the growth of microorganisms in food. Thus, the food spoilage is avoided. If you will store properly, if you preserve your food properly, it will never get spoiled. Next, food protection and food preservation. Food protection means what, children? Food protection means preventing the food spoilage by microbial growth and infestation by pests. Got it? Prevention of food spoilage by microbial growth and infestation by pest is called food protection. And food preservation means what? Use of various preservatives to prevent for a long period of time food spoilage due to internal factors is also called food preservation. Children, you all know the example of preservative, chips, salty chips. Yes, the preservatives they add, that's why it long lasts, like you can eat anytime, like, okay. So preservatives they have to add. Next is organization to look after food safety is FDA, Food and Drug Administration. FDA or Food and Drug Administration is a national government organization. It controls production and distribution of food and drugs by their standardization. As per the Food Safety and Standardization Act 2006, Food Safety and Standardization Authority of India, you must have seen on the packet FSSAI, the full form is Food Safety and Standardization Authority of India has been established. Each eatables, if you check the packets, you will be able to see this mark FSSAI, means full form is Food Safety and Standardization Authority of India, means that food, particular food, is safe to consume. Got it, children? Yes. Next, methods of food preservation or protection. First is freezing. Refrigerators are used, everyone is having refrigerator, right? Refrigerators are used for freezing the food. Due to low temperature of freezers, the biological and chemical reaction in food materials are slowed down. Thus, food remains unspoiled for a longer period. Okay, children? Second is smoking. When the food is preserved with the help of smoke, it is called smoking. Aluminium phosphide is used in smoking method. Okay, children? Next, use of insecticides. There are many chemical insecticides which are sprayed on the containers of grains. Example, Malathion. Insecticides protect the grain by killing infesting insects. Next is irradiation. Food is exposed to ionizing radiations such as high energy electrons emitted by accelerators. Second, X-rays. Third, gamma rays emitted by radioactive isotopes. Irradiation destroys the microbes, insects, etc. This is also a method of food protection. Then, inert gas. Nitrogen gas is filled in airtight package of potato wafers and other food products. This is for prevention of the growth of fungus and insects in them. Got it, children? Then, so this can come in your exams, so children, keep it in your mind. And really, science is always useful in for the whole life. Use of preservatives. Natural preservatives, you all know very well. What are that? salt, sugar, oil, correct? And they have been used in pickles, jams, murabba, petha, etc. Chemical preservatives are synthetic preservatives. Example, acetic acid, vinegar we say, no? In Chinese we add that thing. Citric acid, sodium benzoate, and some nitrate and nitrite salts. These are all chemical preservatives. Okay, children? So these preservatives keep the food safe for a very long duration. And the last is pasteurization. In this method, milk or other similar foodstuffs are heated up to a certain temperature. Example, milk at 80 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes and then quickly cooled. Pasteurization destroys the microbes present in milk and thus milk remains safe. This process was developed by Louis Pasteur. See, this is a great scientist. The microbiologist Louis Pasteur developed the technique of preserving the quality of food by preventing by raising its temperature to prevent microbial growth in the food. Do you know, in Maharashtra, irradiation plants have been installed at Lasalgaon for onions and potatoes and at Navi Mumbai for spices and condiments. Okay, children, so you understood the topic of pasteurization? Yes. So these all are methods of food protection. I will repeat it again: freezing, smoking, use of insecticides, irradiation, use of inert gases. Okay, then use of preservatives like natural preservatives and chemical preservatives, and then last is pasteurization. Okay, these all are methods of food protection. Now the next topic we are going to go for: adulteration. What do you mean by adulteration, children? Adulterated food. Children, what is meant by adulteration of food? Adding cheaper substances of low quality to the food to gain more profits is called food adulteration. The adulterants are harmful for health and consuming such food is wrong. Children, complete the following table. Foodstuffs and adulterant, what they use in milk, what adulterant things they use: water, urea. In the red chili powder, what they use adulterant: brick powder. And the seeds of papaya they use in black pepper. And in ice cream, what they use? They use washing powder and paper pulp. So children, see, these things we eat, and those who are adulterated food stuffs are very harmful for us. Got it, children? The health of all people, young and old, poor or rich, is endangered by food adulteration. So what are the ways of food adulteration? First, the ways of food adulteration. First is removing the important components of food. Example, removal of fat content of milk, essence of cloves, cardamoms, etc. Then what they do? They add harmful color to food. Third, mixing of a low quality, inedible or cheaper material to food. Mixing material like small stones, fine sand, iron filings, urea, dung of horse, sawdust, etc., which are very harmful. These are the ways how they do, how they adulterate the food. Got it, children? And what are the effects of food adulteration, children? The health is affected by food adulteration. Got it? Then laws. See, how will you find out if food has been adulterated? See, milk, the adulterant is, they use water. How you will test? Put a drop of milk on a glass slide and slightly incline it to spread the drop. Conclusion: if the spread mark of milk does not appear milky white, water must have been added to it. See, this is how we can check if the food is adulterated or no. Red chili powder, and what they use in, as an adulterant, brick dust. Take a spoonful of chili powder in a beaker, add water up to a half of the beaker, stir it and leave it undisturbed for a few minutes. What will be the conclusion? If a red layer is seen settled at the bottom of the beaker, it must have been adulterated with brick dust. Turmeric powder, methyl yellow, adulterants they use. And test, take a pinch of turmeric powder in a test tube, add a small quantity of water to it, shake the mixture and add a few drops of concentrated hydrochloric acid. If you will put this, what will be the conclusion? The mixture becomes red on addition of concentrated hydrochloric, and the red color does not disappear if methyl yellow is present. Then rava, fine iron filings they put as an adulterant. How you will test? Pass a magnet through the rava. Conclusion, iron filling adhere to the magnet. They stick to the magnet. See? Yes, these things is going on in our country also. You must have watched Nayak, Mr. India movie also. In that some scene they have shown how they adulterate the food. Next. So children, laws against food adulteration. Parliament passed the Prevention of Food Adulteration Act in 1954. This law has been amended, means changed from time to time. By the amendment of 1976, there is a provision of life imprisonment for the person who does food adulteration with a harmful substance. So nowadays you will not find, but then too they mix up. So directions of the law. First, food should be properly stored. Packing material should not endanger the food or medicine. Clear and legible information should be there on packets about the manufacturing date, expiry date, and instructions for storage. So children, you must have seen, no, on the packets and all, what are the expiry dates, manufacturing date. According to that only you have to buy the products. Okay children. Next, always remember, some chemicals are injected into fruits to make them more attractive and tasty. Milk vendors add urea to the milk so that it appears to have higher fat content. Shopkeepers change the expiry date of the food packets and airtight containers to avoid a financial loss. Calcium carbide and some other chemicals are used to make fruits look more attractive. Example, bright yellow bananas. You can check they are adulterated or no. Frequently, harmful chemicals like carbonated soda, phosphoric acid, etc. are mixed with cold drinks. So you must have heard news also. I will not take brand's name, but many things were wrong in that. So people were banned to drink that particular cold drinks. So children, be aware and be safe. Now we will solve our exercise. Drying, fill in the blanks. Drying the food grains from farms under the hot sun is called dehydration. Materials like milk are instantly cooled after heating up to a certain high temperature. This method of food preservation is called pasteurization. Third, salt is a natural type of food preservative. Vinegar is a chemical type of food preservative. Okay, children. Then question number 2. How is milk pasteurized? So we have read in that pasteurization paragraph also. But I will dictate you the answer here. Okay. The milk is heated up to 80 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes and then cooled it quickly. This destroys the microbes present in the milk and then it can be stored for a longer time. Second question, why should we not consume adulterated food materials? Answer, consuming adulterated food may result into ill health. The various types of adulterations affect our body in different ways. It may result into food poisoning or may cause abdominal discomfort. Some adulterants may affect the functioning of some organs. If contaminated food is consumed over a long period of time, it may cause cancer. Third question, what precautions do your parents take to keep foodstuffs safe? Answer, food gets wasted during the transportation from farm to market. Improper handling. Children, what precautions do your parents take to keep foodstuffs safe? Answer, you can write milk, then our food, how we keep in the refrigerator. Correct, no? Second thing, they don't overcook our food. So these are the personal question. Answer, you can write it by your own. Okay, next question. How does food spoilage occur? Which are the various factors spoiling the food? children? Children, answer for this is the wrong and careless transportation of the foodstuffs from the farm to the customer can cause food spoilage. Second, improper handling, storage and transportation leads to major spoilage. Third, some foodstuffs have intrinsic factors which makes them perishable. Milk, meat, etc. have acidic or alkaline contents which get spoiled soon. Right? So which are the various factors spoiling the food? So these are the things. More you can add, minimum 3 points it's fine, but one more point I'm adding. Microorganisms from the surrounding air, water and land enter the food and cause their deterioration. deterioration. Insects also attack and food, and such infested food is bad for health. Next question. Which method of food preservation would you use? So there are the many preservations, methods of preservation. So you can write 2-3 points from this. Okay. Next, what shall we do? There are vendors selling uncovered food, sweetmeats in open places in market. What shall we do? Children, this is open-minded question. Yes, you will avoid eating outside food. Got it? Yes, children. Then a pani puri wala is serving pani puri with dirty hands. What you will do? We should make other people aware about the possible effects of consuming dirty pani puri. We should also tell the pani puri wala to clean his hands, as he may infect many people with such contamination. Okay, this can you can write by your own personal answer also, children. We have purchased a large quantity of fruits and vegetables. Then what we will do? All the fruits and vegetables that have been purchased from the market should be cleaned by thorough washing. Then they should be wiped with a clean cloth. If they are perishable, they should be stored in refrigerator in a proper way. If there is no refrigerator, then these should be kept in porous basket and covered over with paper or clean cloth. Next, we need to protect foodstuffs from pests like rats, cockroaches, wall lizards, etc. Yes, the foodstuff should be stored in a safe and clean place. The place of storage should be clean, protected and covered. Keeping them in the refrigerator or food cupboard is a better way of protection. Okay, next, find odd man out. Salt, vinegar, citric acid, sodium benzoate. Salt. Okay, second, lakhi dal, brick dust, mitanyl yellow, turmeric powder. Answer, turmeric powder. Banana, apple, guava, almond. Okay, rest these are perishable, no? Then storing, freezing, settling, drying. Storing. Okay. Next, foodstuff adulterant. Mitanyl yellow. This is an adulterant. What is a foodstuff? Turmeric powder. Black pepper. Seeds of papaya. Iron fillings, rava. Honey, water of jaggery. These are adulterant. And people make us fool and we become fool also children. Next, explain why this happens and suggest possible remedies. Qualitative wastage of food. Why it happens? You have to say some points and then remedies also. I'll give you 2 or 3 points. Using wrong methods or protection of food first. Second, excessive use of food preservatives. Third, overcooking of food, washing the vegetables after cutting them. These are the reason. Okay, and what are the remedies? First, finding out the factors that are causing food spoilage. Second, the wrong practices in the kitchen about storage and cooking of food should be changed. Third, proper handling of the fruits and vegetables while bringing them from market. These are the remedies. Upai. Upai bhanta tala. Next, the cooked rice is underdone. When the sufficient water is not added while cooking the rice, then it may remain underdone. Correct? So what is the remedy? The underdone rice may be steamed again after adding some water. It should be thrown away but consumed after re-cooking it. Okay? Next. This your mummy knows, children. The cooked rice is undone. What remedies are there? The wheat that was bought is a bit moist. So, why this happens? The wheat bought from market may not have been stored properly. During rainy season, when there is humid atmosphere, the wheat becomes damp. When the wheat is brought home, it may become damp due to faulty transportation. What is the remedy? Kya upay hai iska? The wheat should not be touched by wet hand. It should be dried in sun for 4 to 5 times. Then the dried wheat should be placed in clean, dry and airtight containers. Okay, next. The taste of yogurt is too sour, slightly bitter. Why this happens? Yogurt is set by using the culture of previous curd. If this culture is bad, it may result into sour or bitter curd. If the yogurt is stored for a long time, it may turn sour or bitter. Storing it at improper temperature also results into similar problem. Then what will be the remedy? Kya upay hai iska? Throw the bitter yogurt. If sour, it can be transformed into buttermilk or add sugar to it. Next. Cut fruits have turned black. So what? Why this happens? The chemical reactions starts in the cut fruits which make them black. And what is the remedy? The pieces of cut fruits should be immediately stored in an airtight containers. Seasoning the fruits pieces with slight sugar or salt also prevents the blackening. Okay, children. Now, next question is, give reason. First, food remains safe at 5 degrees Celsius. Answer, in cold temperature of 5 degrees Celsius, the reactions caused by microorganisms do not take place. Bacteria, fungi, which spoil the food, are inactive at such less temperatures. Therefore, foodstuffs remain safe at this temperature. Next question. Nowadays, food is served buffet style during large gathering. buffet style. Answer: reason why the people are served in a buffet style. Buffet style is introduced to prevent the food wastage and save the food. People are expected to take the amount of food that they can consume. The traditional method of serving the food results into wastage, and hence nowadays food is served buffet style during large gatherings. Okay, children, then too they are wasting food. Okay, here our lesson gets over. Thank you.